And as West 2's Greg Fox reports, it's all aimed at protecting the region's job king, the tourism and convention business.
Taxi service can be a mixed bag. Some convention goers tell us their trip from Orlando International, which strictly regulates cabbies, was top notch.
We had no complaints.
I thought it was pretty outstanding.
Absolutely terrific.
But some people who've gotten cabs between the convention center and their hotels in the iDrive area have complained of inconsistent fares and at times rude or vulgar behavior by drivers.
I pay two different prices coming and going.
Demanding new regulations to improve service, meeting planners say some of the thousands of delegates who spend billions of dollars on our travel and tourism economy might skip Orlando if taxi service stays the same.
Not having fare rates posted that are consistent with the taxis in the rest of the city leaves the rider wondering if everything is on the up and up.
The citizens use your taxis too. I think they deserve safer quality service and competitive rates.
Commissioners got the message, approving a plan to privatize the convention center taxi service. Companies will bid for the job, but will face tough new rules enforcing fares and safety. Independent cabbies tell me that deal could put them out of work.
It is not fair that the monopolies of Orlando take over the convention also. We have nowhere to work.
Supporters say they'll have work with companies that land the new convention center contract. In Orange County, Greg Fox, West 2 News.